Hi everyone, my name's Leila Marchbanks, and I'm here to talk to you about my family's history with gumbo. So, my family is actually from Trinidad and Tobago, and they migrated to Brooklyn, New York in the early 1930s. So, food has always been a bonding element in my family, particularly gumbo. Gumbo comes from the West Indian soup called callaloo. So, callaloo was a soup that all the West Indian villagers used to get together on special occasions and make a huge soup for the village. They would put everything that they had inside the pot. Some would put sausage, some would put crab and shrimp. And obviously, since the West Indies is surrounded by water, a lot of the elements in gumbo are seafood. When the Europeans brought slaves to the Americas, most importantly Louisiana and the East Coast, they brought their West Indian traditions with them, most importantly gumbo. So I hope you enjoy my demonstration of how my family makes gumbo, and happy Black History Month. First, you need a large deep dish pot, and then you have your gumbo based, and I slowly pour in my base just a little bit at a time. And you're gonna do that until all the base is added to the water. All right, so after your base is inside the water, you wanna make sure that your roux is nice and dark. I start with the sausage and the chicken first, and I always wait to add my secondary spices because I wanna make sure that the meats are coated with the spices, so that's why I put the meats in first. After I add my sausage, stir it up a little bit there. And then I can add my chicken. Right, now that I've let the chicken and the sausage cook for about maybe 5, 10 minutes, we're gonna add the shrimp now. Now I'm gonna add my crab. So remember I said I like to use snow crab. It's easier for the roux to get inside of the shell. I usually break my snow crab pieces apart so that all the roux can get inside. All right, next I'm gonna add some bay leaves for flavor. Just laying them right on top there. And then I have my Creole seasoning. And sorry, I don't measure anything. I just kind of eyeball it because I've been making this for a long time. And now I'm adding my Old Bay seasoning, so it's seafood seasoning. Once again, I don't know how much it is. I just kind of eyeball it. And then I'm gonna add some gumbo filet. And then lastly, my grandma just used to use this, just some Red Rooster, literally a couple of dashes. I heard some people add it, some people don't. I like it.
And that is Layla's gumbo. Thank you.